Hey everyone, and welcome to Architecture for Thought. Today we're going to take a quick look at a new AI art and architecture image generator called BlueWillow. I just heard about this, but it sounds like it's been around for a couple months through invitation only, but now it looks like they're opening it up to beta. So I'll leave a link in the description to the website. Looks like you just click on join the free beta and it'll take you to the Discord server. There's also some additional information on this page, basically telling you that right now it's free. I'm sure that will change shortly to become a subscription model, just like Midjourney and some of the other AI generators have become. But when I did, it brought me to basically my Discord page where I logged in. And here it'll land you on the getting started page where there's a few notes. You'll see that it looks very similar to Midjourney. And so for that reason, probably not going to go very deep into the kind of techniques or just how it actually works. I'll put a link to the previous video that I made on Midjourney for that, but there is some good information here, such as the prompt facts. If you go into the fact basic commands, someone wrote out at least some of the commands that are available right now. They only have horizontal commands of aspect ratio 3:2 or 2:3. The standard is 1:1. And it looks like just recently they implemented the image to image so that you can use a uploaded image with a URL. So after that, you will jump in just like Midjourney had into one of these rookie channels and start generating. As you know, these get flooded really quickly with other people's images. So in order to pull some of these out into a private chat, you basically need to scroll until you find a BlueWillow channel or a message from the BlueWillow and right click on that and scroll down to message. And when you do that, it'll open the chat bot in your own personal server. So you can see off to the left-hand side here, I've got my BlueWillow. I opened a private chat. And I've been working through a couple prompts already. As I mentioned, it works extremely similar to Midjourney. When you type in the message box at the bottom, /imagine, that's how you initiate a prompt. And so you'll click on imagine, or you'll type /imagine, and then start to enter your prompt. And so I did that here, and as you can see, as I mentioned, I'm in development of a few images. As you know, these get quite populated with all the varieties and variations and upscalings. So apparently the Discord server operates such that this is a very typical layout. People are saying, you know, look, they basically stole everything from Midjourney, but apparently that's not true, that this button system is just how Discord works, and that is true. However, they also are not using the same AI generated kind of programming behind the scenes. It sounds like they have released a statement that they are not using Midjourney's platform, but they may be using Stable Diffusion. I can't verify that. It does feel a little bit more like the images that I'm generating are like what I created with some of the Stable Diffusion generators. Although these are coming out a little more creative. I came across an article written by this person, Jim, who did a really good job kind of comparing BlueWillow to Midjourney and even showing an example here of the BlueWillow image and a Midjourney image with the same prompt, showcasing that Midjourney is a lot more photorealistic than BlueWillow. The BlueWillow is maybe looking like Midjourney did 6 months back when versions 1 and 2 were out. But I can say, you know, they do feel a little more advanced from what I remember. We're also seeing that the images, if you open the image in a new browser, even the variations, they are larger than Midjourney would produce. And then the final images, they look like they're at the, I think, the 2048 final image size, which is similar to Midjourney. I think I've got one here. Here's a couple of options here. So when they come out and you click open in a new browser, you can enlarge it again, and it's extremely large. As you can see, it's great image size. There are no options to refine or upscale beta after that. Basically, what you see is what you get. You get the four images with your image prompt. It takes about a minute. And then, you know, you have your upscale options, 1, 2, 3, or 4, or variations on 1, 2, 3, or 4. And then that's it. You know, after you basically upscale the image, that's as far as you can take it, you know, before you have to start over again. So that's it in a nutshell. A little bit more behind the scenes. You know, here's their LinkedIn page, and it has a fairly small following, but it sounds like their user base is growing relatively quickly. They're saying that the owners are anonymous, but you can see here there's at least two employees that they show, and there seems to be some sort of link between BlueWillow and Stealth, because I've seen several posts either liked by people through the Stealth company, or promoted by it. So it's interesting. I'm not completely sold on it yet, but it definitely is an alternative to Midjourney that operates very similarly to it. If you like the Discord kind of platform, then certainly, you know, you should experiment with it. And it's actually kind of nice to see that it is operating very similarly to Midjourney. I think it may showcase that we will start to see more competitors that are either also using this platform or just making the kind of dialogue and platform and user interface familiar and friendly, user-friendly between the platforms, so that you're not learning an entirely new platform or software or program every time you're trying to adapt to some of these. So that's about it. I'll run a few images of my upscales after this. You know, again, feel free to revisit one of my Midjourney prompts videos to take some of those prompts and plug them in here. I've got a whole dialogue Google Doc of prompts that I keep, that I recommend all of you do the same, just because you never know when these servers may go down and you might not have access to your prompts. So it's a good idea to just always keep your prompts in a safe place. Thanks for watching, and as I mentioned, I'll run some images here at the end. And I do want to mention that I am working on a lecture that I was graciously invited to give on AI and architecture, and it's going to feature a little more about workflows and starting to get away from just simply producing images, but looking at different methods for taking the images a bit further or implementing some deeper architectural concepts into integrating AI with architecture. So stay tuned for that. As always, thanks for watching. Bye. If you're still here, you may be seeking more thoughts on AI and architecture. So here's a short excerpt from the lecture I will be giving on this topic. AI is like a child with infinite knowledge. Knowledge is a set of facts and rule sets based on experience, and different experiences can produce different knowledge sets. And so we are now entering a topic of discussion that is as old as civilization, which is how to define truth. You may be familiar with Plato's allegory of the cave thought experiment, or his theory of forms proposition. Both were exercises in questioning how we observe or qualify truth, And here again, we are faced with the overwhelming task of assigning value and defining objects, spaces, emotions, and faces only one-dimensionally through natural language text prompting. We are leaning on AI to establish non-negotiables, which Plato called forms, by training AI to recognize hundreds or millions of forms that enable us to generate what Plato then called particulates, or what we describe as iterations or generations from those known forms. Why this matters is in order to be a good prompt engineer and to create precise forms or emergent particulates, we need to understand both how the AI is trained to recognize forms and how to be a good systems thinker or composer of forms to create these unique particulates that have the potential to be new branches of evolution or create subgenres of form that are unidentifiable by any intelligence, AI, or mankind. This will allow us to remain in control of mankind's destiny.